And welcome back to another episode of the Book Club in the Bottle. Book Club, yay! Let's go! So, guys, today we are on extremely exciting episode because today, guys, we're episode 197. Damn! Can you imagine? I'm really excited about it. I'm getting really excited. Excited about the fact that we are almost, we are only 3 episodes to go. We need to go 3 more episodes, only 3 left, 3 episodes left. And to it's a special 12th episode, so let's go, let's go. It's me, that's what's up. So guys, first of all, I really want to say thank you very much, guys, for joining me. I really appreciate the fact that you invest some time, with me. And support me in my journey. About 1 million episodes. Let's go. Guys, if you're new to the channel, welcome. And if you're already familiar with the channel, welcome back. My name is again the host. And my goal from this, and guys, I truly believe that English is the number one tool that each one must require in order to be successful in life. And the second tool that is going to bless a lot. To bless a lot is to know how to communicate in front of the camera. I'm aware of the fact that a lot of people have a lack of self-confidence to speak and not have self-confidence to speak in English or appear on the camera. My soul struggle with pronunciation or whatever. And in this podcast, we are working together to improve our English speaking level and on our communication skills to stand for the camera and to communicate well for the camera. And I'm doing so by give me, for example, my style is by showing you my own journey, my struggles, my success, and my own failures to speak in English and to stand in front of the camera. And by doing so, I really hope it will inspire you and a lot of people around the world to also work on in English, to speak in English, to send the message in the world and to make a difference because we're here. Guys, I hope this episode will inspire you guys. And guys, you see, we are celebrating, we have this really nice, I don't know if it's a future, it's a far future, but I think if Elon Musk, we never know, maybe we can see this, I just looked at my glasses, you can see, I'm the chair. You can see because of my names. Maybe in the future we can see Elon Musk make us this city very soon. You never know. And guys, if you want to check out this grand background, you can find it over 3, 2, 1 per day. You can find it on Good Fun. And this grand background was uploaded to Good Fun by Kipish Fun on 17 November 2018. And if you want to download the background, just need to press download. You can choose the resolution over here. Press download. Right click, Shimato on the Chevy Nimo or Set Picture S. Click on it, choose when you want to save it, press save and come back just like that. You got this great background on your computer. So thank you very much for keeping fun and thank you very much for this woman who made this great background. And of course, guys, believe, thumb up, they really love this. Great background. And today we'll continue on habit 6 for the 7 habits of highly effective people by Stephen Covey. Really nice book. Enjoy it, I love it, and let's go. And guys, if you want to check out this grand background, don't. If you want to check out the book of Stephen Covey, you got all the links in the description below, so make sure to check them out. And another thing, guys, if you enjoyed the video, please like it, share it with your friends, subscribe to the channel, and push the notification bell so you will be notified on each time that extremely exciting episodes are coming to YouTube. And you definitely don't want to miss the episode. Special edition of episode 200. So let's go. Yeah, it's an small effort from your side and it's going to help me a lot. So thank you very much. And let's go, guys. And about the introduction of the data writing to the book. So the 7 habits of highly effective people. By Stephen Covey, page 266. Yeah, damn, we almost finished the book. Need but the legend, the one and the many seven gives don't please. Oh boy, okay, let's go, that's me. Let's go. And this episode, we finish with the this agreement, an example of a couple that want to go into vacation. Let's go. Because they have emotional bank. They have trust and open communication in the range. Because the thing win-win is they believe in a field alternative, a solution that is mutually beneficial and is better than what either of them originally proposed. Because they listen empathically, and seek first to understand, they create within themselves and between them a comprehensive picture of the values and the concerns that need to be taken into account in making a decision. And the combination of those ingredients, the emotional bank account, thinking win-win, and seeking things to understand, create the ideal environment for a synody. Buddhism called this the middle way. Middle in this essence does not mean a compromise. It means higher, like the apex of the triangle. He's searching for the middle or why away. This husband and wife realize that their love, the relationship, is part of the synergy. As they communicate, the husband really deeply feels his wife's desire. He needs to be with her mother. He understands how she wants to relieve her sister, who is the primary responsibility for the mother's care. He understands that they really don't know how long she will be with them, and that she certainly is more important than fishing. And that she certainly is more important than fishing. And the wife deeply understands her husband's desire to have the family together and to provide a great experience for the boys. She realizes the investment that has been made in lessons and equipment to prepare for this fishing vacation. And she feels the importance of creating good memories with them. So they pull those desires. And they are not on opposite sides of the problem. They are together on one side, looking at the problem, understanding the needs, and working to create a field alternative that will meet them. Maybe we could arrange another time within the month for me to visit your mom, he suggested. I could take over the own responsibilities for the weekend and arrange for some help at the first of the week so that you could go. I know it's important to you to have the time. Or maybe we could locate a place you can find fish that would be close to your mother. The area wouldn't be as nice, but it could still be outdoors and meet as needs as well. And the boys wouldn't be climbing the walls. We could even plan some recreational activities with the cousins, aunts, and uncles, which would be an added benefit. They synergize. They communicate back and forth. At least they come up with a solution and they both feel good about it. It's better than the solution that either of them originally proposed. It's better than a compromise. It's a synergetic solution that builds a peace and peace. Instead of a transaction, it's a transformation. They get what they both really want and build their relationship in the process. Title: Negative Synergy. Seeking the field alternative is a major paradigm shift from the dichotomous either/or mentality. But look at the difference in results. How much negative energy is typically expended when people try to solve problems or make decisions in an interdependent reality? How much time is spent in confessing other people's sins, politicking anybody? Rivalry. Interpersonal conflict, protecting one's backsides. Backside, masterminding, and second, guessing. It's like trying to drive down the road with one foot on the gas and the other foot on the brake. And instead of getting a foot off the brake, most people give it more gas. They try to apply more pressure, more eloquence, more logic, more logical information to strengthen the opposition. The problem is that highly independent people are trying to succeed in an independent reality. They are either dependent on a boring strength, opposition power, and they go for win-loss, or they are independent on being popular with others, and they go for last win. They might all win-win a technique, but they don't really want to listen. They want to manipulate. And synergy can't thrive in that environment. Insecure people think that all reality should be amenable to their paradigms. They have a high need to clone others, to mold them over into their own thinking. They don't realize that the very strength of the relationship is in having another point of view. Sameness is not oneness. Uniformity is not unity. Unity or oneness is complementariness, not sameness. Sameness is uncreative and boring. The essence of synergy is to value the differences. I can't believe that the key to interpersonal synergy is interpersonal synergy. That is synergy within ourselves. The art of interpersonal synergy is embodied in the principles in the first three habits, which gives the internal security sufficient to end the risks of being open and vulnerable. By internalizing those principles, we develop the abundance mentality of win-win and the authenticity of habit 5. One of the very practical results of being a principle-centered is that it makes us whole, truly integrated. People who are scripted deeply illogical, verbal, left brain thinking, will discover how totally inadequate that thinking is in solving problems which require a great deal of creativity. They become aware and begin to open up a new script inside their right brain. It's not that the right brain wasn't there. It just lay dormant. The muscles had not been developed, or perhaps they had out of it after any childhood. Because of the heavy left-brain emphasis of normal education or social scripting. When a person has access to both the intuitive, creative, and the visual right brain, and the analytical, logical, done by left brain, then the whole brain is working. In other words, there is a psychic synergy taking place in our own bed. And this tool is best suited to the reality of what life is. Because life is not just logical, it is also emotional. One day I was presenting a seminar which I titled Manage from the Left, Lead from the Right, the company in Orlando, Florida. During the break, the president of the company came up to me and said, Stefan, this is intriguing, but I've been thinking about this material from more in terms of its application to my marriage and to my business. My wife and I have a real communication problem. I wonder if you would have lunch with the two of us and just kind of watch how we talk to each other. Let's do it, I am fine. As we sat down together, we exchanged a few present tenses. Then his man turned to his wife and said, "No, I have invited Stefan to have lunch with us to see if he could help us in our communication with each other. I know you feel I should be a more sensitive, considerate husband. Would you give me something specific you think I ought to do?" His dominant left brain wanted facts. He goes specifics and parts. "Well, as I've told you before, it's nothing specific. It's more of a general sense I have about prioritize." Now, dominant right brain was dealing with sensing and with a gestalt, the role, the relationship between the parts. "What do you mean a general feeling about prioritize? What is it you want me to do? Give me something specific I can get a handle on." "Well, it's such a feeling." The right one was dealing in images, intuitive feelings. "I just don't think our marriage is as important to you as you tell me it is." "Well, what can I do to make it more important? Give me something concrete and specific to go on." He started to put into words. At that point, he just rolled his eyes and looked at me as if to say, "Stefan, will you endure this kind of dumbness in your marriage?" "Just a feeling," she said, "a very strong feeling." "Honey," he said, "well, that is your problem, and that is the problem with your mother. In fact, it's the problem with every woman I know." Then he began to interrogate us as though it was some kind of legal deposition. "Do you live where you want to live?" That is not it. She signed. That is not it at all. "I know," he replied with a forced patience. "But since you won't tell me exactly what it is, I think the best way to find out what it is to find out what it is not. Do you live where you want to live?" "Again. Do you want to leave?" "I guess." "And Stefan zeroes for just a few minutes to try to help us. Just give me a quick yes or no answer. Do you leave when you want to leave? "Yes." "Okay, that is said. Do you have the things you want to have?" "Yes." "All right, you do the things you want to do." This went on for a little while, and I could see it wasn't helping at all. So I intervened and said, "Is this kind of how it goes in your relationship?" "Every day, Stefan," he replied. "It's a story of our marriage," she signed. SIGHED. Oh, for a long time, I didn't say it. Spell the word. I looked at the two of them, and the thought crossed my mind as about two elf brain people living together. "Do you have any children?" I asked. "Yes, two." "Really?" I asked incredulously. "How did you do it? What do you mean how did we do it? "You were synergetic," I said. "R plus one usually equals two. But you made one plus one equals four. Now that is synergy. The world is greater than the sum of its parts. So how did you do it?" "You know we did it," he replied. "You must have valued the differences," I exclaimed. Valuing the differences is the essence of synergy. The mental, the emotional, the psychological differences between people. And the key to varying those differences is to realize that all people see the world not as it is, but as they are. Guys, guess what? This is the end of the episode. You know what it means? It means that we are getting really, really close to the special episode. Two more episodes to go, and then we arrive the special episode two for 200 episodes. But anyway, to do me, I really appreciate the fact that you should to waste your best time with me and all this podcast inspiring you. But there's some kind of inspiration for you guys to work in English and speak in English, to speak your truth, and to share your message with the world. Guys, well, it's part of all the catechism because you are here, and I really hope to see you all tomorrow, guys, for the next episode, extremely exciting episode of the Guys Book Club in the World. Thank you, Book Club. And please have a good time. Take care of yourself, and bye-bye. So guys, the day today it's Monday, and today is the 4th of October 2021, and time now is 10:54. התאריך היום מוביל לעשרים 2021, השעה היא עכשיו 10:54, יום שני, ועל המחר, במשרה ראשונה, במחר מקבל מפתח לדר לאריאל, אחר במשרה ראשונה מועצת תלמידים, מועצת סטודנטים, מלא מחגש. מנהל תאים במועדונים, יהיה לנו ברכה והצלחה, מתרגש, שני בחיים, מנהל זאת כמו שאני מכיר, עד אחרי אני בבית, הכל היה נחמד, סרטים על השגרה שלנו, הדרך הכיפית עם המשפחה וההורים, ענבל עם הוויצ'אז, מנהל, ועכשיו יאללה, סגנון חדש של החיים, נפלת מחלק אחד לחיים שלי, חלק חיים חדש בחיים, של יום יום מת, זה מעגל, מוות, חיים, נאמר דיפה שאני הולך לעשות. אז סיימנו את המעגל הראשון, עכשיו הגיע הזמן להתחילת המעגל השני, מה של פחד, תחילה של אותה, בריאתה, יצירתה לדעתה של פחד חדשה, ברכה והצלחה, ונעתנו להמשך, ביי.